What's going on, everyone? Ray DelVecchio here. This question was part of a previous monthly Q&A for business plan members. Now, if you think you're ready to make money with your skills, sign up for the freelancing membership on my website, where you can download all of my web design, WordPress, and online marketing giveaways in one spot. And that includes a PDF copy of my book, Create Your Freedom. I'll include a link here in the corner of this video and in the description below to create your free account. Now, let's get to today's freelancing question. The first question that I got is, what are common problems that you face with client work? And I've said this many times, most of my clients are home service contractors. So the majority of the work that I do on their websites is simply adding new photos, graphics, certificates, wording, stuff like that. Every year they get new insurance certificates and state licensing, so usually they want that on the website. I always encourage them to add new photos when they complete a project. Some of my clients are good with that, others aren't so good. You know, another example is one of them wanted to put like a cash discount on there, a 2% cash discount or something along those lines. And he wanted me to create just a simple graphic and add that to the home page. So it's really simple stuff. You know, I tell them that I'm not going to change the layout, but I'm always willing to update the content, you know, as often as they want. And I know just with my types of clients, they're not going to overwhelm me. If you have somebody that's a lot, you know, more computer savvy, they're taking photos all the time, they have a ton of ideas, that might be a problem for you. But that's something that I think is willing to risk, you know, offer them the unlimited monthly updates and just put some type of disclaimer on there that there's a limit up to how many hours per month you can possibly work. Something like that in an email, just so you have that. You don't have to overcomplicate any of this. Most people are good people and they're not going to try and screw you. And if somebody does, then you just move on. You know, don't waste any time or energy on them if it's not a big project. So the other thing, you know, the one thing that I think I had the most trouble with by far was just explaining tech jargon to my clients in a language that they understand. This is both relevant when you're trying to sell a web design or a website to somebody, and also when you're managing it, trying to drive traffic to it, and maybe doing some things that they don't quite understand, you know, the strategy behind it, because they're not actively involved with the online world or social media. So that's something it took me a long time to get good at, and that's in particular because I've just been a tech guy, computer guy my whole life, so this is kind of second nature to me, and I can sort of ramble on at times when it comes to some of this tech stuff. And you got to be perceptive of your client. You know, if they're not saying anything, if they don't know what to say, and maybe if their eyes are glazing over, you know, this is the advantage of meeting in person. You can kind of get a better read of what they're thinking. You just need to simplify as much as you can. They prefer simple versus complicated. You know, I think most people think they have to have some type of complicated solution to be worthy of the monthly price or the monthly cost. In reality, if you could just solve their problems and just be able to communicate with them fast if there are any problems, that's all they really want. And the last few bullets that I got here are what I consider to be, you know, the clients that aren't putting in the effort. And those are the people that it's tough to get content from them. They might have a lot of ideas with what they want on the website, but when you start to say, like, I need, you know, these five pictures, I need wording for these five pages, they're going to go silent. It's going to be hard to get it from them. And in a lot of ways, I just think you might want to build that into their package so you can launch as quickly as possible. Ultimately, they might not stay on with you if they're not doing the effort, because they're not going to be getting the value from it if they're not taking advantage of the services that you offer and what you're willing to do under the unlimited plan. These are the people that they just want the easy button. And I've had a bunch of clients like this where they tell me, I don't want to have to send you anything. I don't want to use my phone and do all the stuff that I'm not used to. I just want you to take care of it. But then they're questioning when there's no results coming in. So in the end, you got to deal with a few bad clients to be able to spot them. But in my experience, those are the ones that are going to be the problem clients, the ones that it takes them forever to put into action the advice that you're giving them. You know, I like to give a lot of advice to my clients, and very few of them actually do it. And I think this is just human nature. You know, most of the world, I almost hate to say this, but most of the world, they're not action takers. They overthink, or they don't even think. And I think that's the worst case. You know, I'm a classic overthinker, and it took me a long time to develop the mindset of just doing things and progressing and building momentum. all of my best clients know about this, and they're the ones that we always have a conversation every couple of weeks to keep things moving. When you start to not hear from somebody for a while, that's when, you know, the results might not come in. But I've also had a couple clients that have paid me monthly for years because they just want the website presence. So they don't necessarily care as much about the traffic. It's more so a portfolio of their work for their potential clients that they get through referrals. So there's a sneak peek of the monthly Q&A. And if you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials and help as you begin your journey of working for yourself as a freelancer. If you have a question, feel free to leave it in the comments below and I just might answer it in a future video. Also, don't forget to sign up to the free membership to get access to all of my website freebies. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch, and I hope you join me on the next video.